Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to my channel, Hooked in Loops. If you have still not subscribed to my channel, then please hit the subscribe button. And for getting updates of new videos, then please click the bell icon. Today I will show you how to make this beautiful crochet dream catcher mandala, and for that I have used a 3mm crochet hook and acrylic yarn. First we will take the white color yarn and loop it around our fingers in this manner. Then we will insert our hook below the first loop and draw the second loop in this manner. Yarn over and draw the yarn through that loop, and we formed the magic circle. After that we will do a chain 3. This is the first double crochet of this round. Then we will do a chain 1 for the chain 1 space. Then in the magic circle we will do a double crochet, okay, and followed by a chain 1. Again we will do a double crochet in the magic circle followed by a chain 1 again. In this manner there is a total of 12 double crochets, taking the first chain 3 as a double crochet with a chain 1 after each double crochet in this round. We will quickly complete our double crochets. We have completed all the 12 double crochets in this round. After the last double crochet, we will do a chain 1 and we will complete this round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round, followed by a chain 1, and we will cut the yarn and pull it in this manner. So the first round is complete. Okay. After the first round, we will take a purple colored yarn, make a slip knot, and then we will insert the hook in it. We will slip stitch the purple colored yarn in any of the chain 1 space of the previous round. After the slip stitch we will do a chain 3. In the same chain 1 space we will do 3 double crochets. After the 3 double crochets, we will do a chain 2, then we will skip the following chain 1 space, and then in the next chain 1 space, we will just do a slip stitch. After that, we will do a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch, pull the loop, take out the hook and keep it as it is. Okay. Then we will take a sky blue colored yarn or any yarn of your choice and make a slip knot. We will slip stitch that sky blue colored yarn in the same chain 1 space where we ended our violet colored yarn. After the slip stitch we will do a chain 3, and in the same chain 1 space we will do 3 double crochets. After that we will do a chain 2, then we will skip the following chain 1 space, and right after that in the following chain 1 space we will do a slip stitch followed by a chain 1. Okay. We will take another yarn and make a slip knot and insert the hook in it. We will then slip stitch the green colored yarn in the same chain 1 space where we ended our sky blue colored yarn, followed by a chain 3, and 3 double crochets in the same chain 1 space. Okay, I hope you understood the pattern for this first round. We will continue doing like this with 3 more different colors. Okay, after these 3 double crochets, we will do a chain 2 and we will skip the next chain 1 space, and in the following chain 1 space, we will do a slip stitch followed by a chain 1. In this same chain 1 space, we will slip stitch another yarn, okay, and do our stitches accordingly. We completed the first round, okay. At the end of the chain 2, we will simply slip stitch in the chain 1 space where we began, followed by a chain 1 to secure that slip stitch. Now we will begin the next round. We will do the round 2 and round 3 together, as I will show you. At first, we will take the hook and insert it into the third chain of the starting chain 3 of any set. Okay, we inserted the hook in the third chain of this purple colored set. Then we will insert the hook in the pink colored yarn, that loop, okay, and we will just pull it through that stitch, followed by a chain 3. We will turn our work and then we will start doing a double crochet in the first double crochet stitch from the hook, okay, in this manner. Then in the next double crochet stitch, we will do another double crochet and one more double crochet in the following stitch. Then we will do the last double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the previous round of this pink colored one. Okay, we completed the round 2. Now we will begin the round 3 with a chain 3. Turn our work and in the next 3 double crochet stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. We will do chain 4 and pull the loop and take out the hook. If you want, you can attach a stitch marker there. Okay, so we did 2 rounds, that is round 2 and round 3 for the pink colored set. Now we will do the round 2 and round 3 for the purple colored set. For this, we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of that blue colored set. And from the back, we will pull the purple colored loop, okay, in this manner. Just pull that loop through that third stitch and then we will do a chain 3. We will turn our work and we will do 1 double crochet in each of the following 3 stitches. Okay, that is 1, 2 and 3. Then we will do 1 double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the previous round of this purple colored set. And with this, we will complete our second round. We will begin the round 3 with a chain 3 and we will turn our work. In the following 3 stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. We will then do a chain 4 and after that we will pull the loop and take out the hook. we did a round 2 and round 3 of the purple color yarn. Now we will insert our hook in the loop of that pink colored chain, and we will slip stitch in the double crochet stitch of the second round of that purple colored set in this manner. Okay, and we will do a slip stitch followed by a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch, pull the loop and take out the hook. Okay, now we will do the round 2 and round 3 for that blue colored set. For that we will insert our hook as we did earlier in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of that green colored set and pull the blue colored loop through it. Then we will do a chain 3 and then we will turn our work and we will do one double crochet in each of the following double crochet stitches. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3, and then we will complete this round 2 with a double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this blue of that first round of that blue colored set. Okay, and then we will do a chain 3 to begin the round 3. And we will turn our work. Okay, and in the following 3 stitches we will do 1 double crochet each. Followed by a chain 4. And we will pull the loop and take out the hook. We will insert our hook in that purple colored loop. Okay. And we will slip stitch in the first double crochet stitch from the hook of that second round. Followed by a chain 1 to secure this slip stitch, pull the loop and take out the hook. Okay, so in this way we will complete the second and third round of the remaining 3 colors. Okay, we are left with the orange colored one. So we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this pink colored set. And we will pull that orange colored loop through this stitch. Okay, and we will do chain 3 and we will turn our work, and in the following 3 stitches we will do 1 double crochet each. And in the Then we will do 1 double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this first round to complete this round 2, and after that we will do a chain 3 to begin the round 3 of this orange colored set, and in the following 3 stitches we will do 1 double crochet each. Okay, and after that we will do a chain 4 and then we will simply slip stitch in the double crochet stitch of that second round of that pink colored set and do a chain 1, pull the loop, take out the hook. We will insert a hook in that loop of that yellow colored yarn, and we will slip stitch in the first double crochet from the hook of that second round, and we'll do a slip stitch followed by chain one and pull the loop and take out the hook. So we completed 3 rounds. Okay. We'll proceed with round 4 and 5. For that we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3. Okay. Of that round 3, and we will pull the pink colored loop from the back and do a chain 5. Then we will turn our work. In the following 3 double crochet stitches of the previous round, we will do 1 double crochet each. And in the last stitch, that is in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the previous round, we will do 1 double crochet. Okay. We completed the round 4, we will begin the round 5 with a chain 3 and we will turn our work. In the following 3 stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. Okay, and after that we will do chain 6. And we will pull our loop and take out the hook. We will do the round 4 and round 5 for the orange colored set. For that we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 3 of the pink colored set and pull the orange colored loop from the back followed by chain 5. Then we will turn our work. In the following 3 double crochet stitch, we will do 1 double crochet each. Okay. And then in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 3, we will do 1 double crochet and we completed the round 4. We will begin the round 5 with a chain 3 and turn our work. In the following 3 stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. And then we will do chain 6. Stitch in the double crochet stitch of the fourth round and then we will do a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch. In order to do the round 4 and 5 of the violet colored set, we will do the same thing as we did earlier. Okay. Instead of using 6 different colors, we can do the entire pattern with a single colored yarn. In that case, the pattern would be quite continuous and it would look very pretty and classy as well. There will be little changes in the pattern. If you want me to do the tutorial on that, then comment in the comment section. I will do the tutorial. Okay. Since we are using 6 different colors, we are able to do the respective round 4 and 5 for those particular colors. There is no continuity in this pattern. Okay. We will slip stitch the pink colored loop into the double crochet stitch of the fourth round followed by a chain 1. We completed our round 4 and 5 for the orange, pink and purple colored yarn. We will repeat it with the other 3 colors too. So we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 3 of the orange colored set and pull the yellow colored loop through that stitch. We will do chain 5. Okay, we will turn our work. In the following 3 double crochet stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. Okay, and in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 3 of that yellow colored set, we will do a double crochet. We completed the round 4 and begin the round 5 with a chain 3 and turn our work. In the following 3 double crochet stitches, we will do 1 double crochet each. and after that we will do chain 6. Then we will slip stitch in the double crochet stitch of that fourth round. Followed by a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch. We will slip stitch the green colored loop into the first double crochet stitch of that fourth round. Followed by a chain 1 to secure that. We completed 5 rounds of the spiral design. We will need one more round to do. So let's do it. Insert your hook in the third chain of any colored set. Okay, like this. And pull the green colored loop from back. And we will do chain 7. We will turn our work and as usual, we will do one double crochet in each of the following 3 stitches. The number of double crochet stitches remains the same in each step, only the number of chains are increasing. Okay? I hope you noticed that. We will complete this round with a double crochet. In the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 5, and we will just do a chain 1, pull the loop and take out the hook. You can also cut the yarn, we will eventually cut it later. Let's do the round 6 of the blue color loop. Hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 5 of the green colored set and pull the blue colored loop and do chain 7. Then turn your work and we will do 3 double crochets, one in each of the following 3 stitches. Okay. Then we will do the last double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of that fifth round of the same set. Do a chain 1 and we completed the sixth round. Okay. Now it's better to cut the yarn. Okay. Otherwise it will jumble up all the yarns together. Pull that loop and tighten the stitch. Okay. Do the same thing with the green colored yarn which we did earlier and pull that loop to tighten the stitch. Okay, now we will do the sixth round for that yellow colored set. For that we will pull the yellow colored loop through the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 5 of orange colored set and then do chain 7. We will turn our work and in each of the following stitches we will do one double crochet each. Do the last double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the round 5 of the same set and do a chain 1 and cut the yarn. Done. Okay, so we completed all the colors except the last one, that is the pink colored set. For that we will insert our hook in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the fifth round of that purple colored set and pull the pink colored loop through that stitch. In this manner we will do chain 7 and we will turn our work. Then we will do one double crochet in each of the following 3 stitches. And after that, we will do the last double crochet in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the fifth round of the same colored set, followed by a chain 1, and we will cut the yarn. And our mandala is complete. So the basic mandala is now ready. We will now stitch it up with the metallic ring. You can also stitch it up with a wooden ring if you get that. Okay. So we will take a white colored yarn for that and make a slip knot and insert the hook in it. We will insert the hook in the last double crochet stitch of each colored set and put the hook below the metallic ring in this manner. We will pull the yarn through that stitch, taking that metallic ring, and do a slip stitch. And then we will secure the slip stitch with a chain 1. Okay. And then we will do a single crochet by inserting the hook in the same stitch and pulling the yarn in this manner and doing a single crochet. So we attached the mandala to the metallic ring. Now we are going to do 20 single crochets in that metallic ring, that is around the rim of that ring. Okay, so we will slowly do 20 single crochets in that metallic ring. After your 20 single crochets are done, we will insert our hook in the last double crochet of the next color stitch and pull the yarn through it, taking the metallic ring, and do a single crochet there. I hope you understood how we joined the mandala to the metallic ring with a single crochet. Then again we will do 20 single crochet only in the metallic ring, not taking the mandala. Okay. And after we have done the 20 single crochets again, we will insert our hook in the last double crochet stitch of the next color, put our hook below that metallic ring and pull the yarn through it. Okay, and then we will do a single crochet and join the mandala again. And then again we will do 20 single crochets in the metallic ring. In this way we will continue doing 20 single crochets in the metallic ring and then joining the next colored set to the metallic ring. Okay, we completed doing 20 single crochets and we will join the last yellow colored set to the metallic ring by doing a single crochet in the last double crochet with the metallic ring, and then we will complete our dream catcher with the last 20 single crochets. Now we will complete it this round with a slip stitch in the first single crochet of this round, and after the slip stitch we will do as many chains as we want in order to make the loop for hanging this dream catcher. I made a total of 40 chains because that was a suitable length I found for hanging my mandala. Okay, and then at the end we will slip stitch in the same stitch where we began doing our chains. Okay, and after the slip stitch we will simply do a chain 1 and we will cut the yarn. We will weave in the loose ends. And finally, our spiral mandala dream catcher is ready. You just need to decorate it with feathers or tassels in whatever way you feel like. So my pattern was till this portion. I hope you liked this tutorial and it was easy to understand it. If you have any queries, then comment in the comment section. I will solve your queries. Free to give any suggestions in the comment section. Like my video, share it to the fullest, and please subscribe to my channel. And thank you. Have a great day.